Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Dokkan Battle video. So, Fizz Angel Golden Frieza is going to be dropping on the global side of the game in about a day and a half. So, in today's video, I want to give you guys a full preview of everything you need to know about this unit, including his super attack animations, his full kit breakdown, and of course, his potential banner on global to help you guys decide whether or not you want to spend your hard-earned Dragon Stones to try and pull him, or if you should be holding onto those stones for something else in the future. Okay, now before we get into his banner or his, you know, details, let's start by watching his animations because they are absolutely fire, man. Okay, so let's pop over to the Dokkan Twitter page and I'm gonna pop on my headphones and here we go. Yo, I don't know about you guys, but to me, that's fire, man. Especially the transformation, right? Like when he transforms from Final Form Frieza, this right here, to Angel Golden Frieza, like, it's gotta be the best transformation animation in the entire game. And yes, even better than Cooler, okay? And that's no disrespect to Cooler. Cooler is amazing, still one of my favorite units in the game, especially from an animations perspective. But I gotta say, Frieza has a better transformation. Okay, and yeah, there you go, guys. Great start to the video. If you guys are into fire animations, which, I mean, you should be, right? Then this guy's got you covered. Okay, so from there, let's pop over to his banner now. This, of course, was his JP banner. We don't know exactly what the global banner is going to look like, but for the most part, for these normal Dokkan Fizz banners, global and JP are identical, or at least very, very similar. Like, there might be one unit that gets swapped out, maybe Beerus, because he has been featured a couple times in the past, like recent past, right? So they might swap out Beerus for, I don't really know, maybe Bardock or something like that. But yeah, for the most part, it will be a similar banner. And as you can see, man, the JP banner was actually very, very good. We have Frieza, we have Beerus, we have Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku, we have STR Cooler, we have Namek Goku. Now these two, not as exciting, but obviously it makes sense because the main unit is a Frieza, so they included the tech transforming Frieza and also the Int Angel Golden Frieza. Now I'm not gonna freak out and say this is like the best Dokkan Fizz banner we've ever seen, because it's not, right? Like, it's good. It's very, very good, but it's definitely not the best we've seen. So if I were to give it a rating out of 10, I would say this banner is like a solid 8, maybe 8.5 out of 10 compared to like other, you know, normal Dokkan Fizz banners. You can't really compare it to Dual Dokkan Fizz or Anniversaries or anything like that, because those are just like a different category, right? So anyways, guys, that's the banner. I think it's very solid as long as they keep it exactly the same or very similar. Like I said, if they swap out like Beerus, for example, and give us another top tier Dokkan Fizz like Bardock or Kefla or even Int Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, Tech Super Buu, so on and so forth, then yeah, this is going to be a very, very good banner. Okay, so from there, let's move on to the details for Frieza himself. Now, of course, I did cover this in a previous video, so if you guys have seen that video, then you don't have to, you know, watch this part. But for anybody that missed it, for anybody that doesn't know what he does, let's jump in. Okay, so his leader skill is Resurrected Warriors or Otherworld Warriors. Category key plus 4, HP, attack, and defense plus 150%. Now, he doesn't lead a new category, which is something that is kind of uncommon with new Dokkan Fizz units, right? Usually, when a new Dokkan Fizz unit comes out, they bring a unique, brand new category with them. But for Frieza, It's Resurrected Warriors and Otherworld Warriors, which are two existing categories in the game. So if you guys, you know, specifically summon for Dokkan Fest units because you want to run new categories, this Frieza will not provide that for you, but he does give you a very good leader skill for one of the better categories in the game, Resurrected Warriors. Key plus 4 is awesome, right? Because if you're running double Friezas, then that's already key plus 8 for every unit on the team before factoring in their passives and of course orbs, right? Now, I personally don't have an issue with this because I've always felt like they were introducing too many new categories too quickly, and a lot of these categories are just like super random and super convoluted. So I'm totally cool with the idea of just taking a break from that for a while and instead focusing on giving a boost to some of the older categories, right? So that's his leader skill, Resurrected Warriors, Otherworld Warriors, and his super attack raises defense and causes immense damage and seals a super attack. So this can of course be stacked infinitely, which means that on a longer event, he is super, super tanky. And his passive is attack and defense plus 100%, plus an additional attack and defense plus 50% for 5 turns and medium chance of evading enemies' attacks, including super attacks, within the same turn after receiving an attack, and attacked enemies attack and defense minus 30% for 2 turns. His active skill transforms him into Angel Golden Frieza, and it can be activated upon entering the attacking turn once only. So basically, this is the easiest transformation slash active skill condition that you can possibly have, because you can activate it as soon as he enters the rotation. So it could be on turn 1, maybe turn 2, or turn 3 if you're really unlucky, but I love this. Okay, they should definitely do this more with future active skills. And his links are Prodigies, Strongest Clan in Space, Universe's Most Malevolent, Shocking Speed, Nightmare, Tournament of Power, and Fierce Battle. And categories are Resurrected Warriors, Universe Survival Saga, Representatives of Universe 7, Transformation Boost, Full Power, Wicked Bloodline, and Otherworld Warriors. And finally, the additional attack and defense plus 50% on his passive is calculated separately, resulting in a total boost of attack and defense plus 200% after being attacked, on top of the medium chance to avoid enemy attacks, and also of course the debuffing of attacked enemies. So yeah, overall, if this Frieza honestly didn't have a transformation, he would already, in my opinion, be a very solid unit, like a really, really good unit. But he does have the transformation, which can be activated on turn 1. So let's pop over to this Angel Golden Frieza now. His super attack massively raises attack for 1 turn and causes immense damage, and this is a 100% boost to his super attack multiplier. His passive is attack and defense plus 120%, plus an additional attack and defense plus 80%, and great chance of stunning the attacked enemy when performing a super attack. Reduces damage received by 50% when HP is 49% or less. And of course, because of the way it's calculated, his passive actually provides attack and defense plus 296% when performing a super attack. So this Frieza, it's super, super hard, has the potential to be very, very, very tanky, and that's pretty much all you can ask for, man. I mean, what more do you want from a unit, right? Great defense, great offense, a lot of versatility with the transformation, and yeah, there's really nothing negative I can say about this unit. I absolutely love him, and I'm probably going to be going pretty deep for at least a copy and a dupe once his banner drops. So there you go, guys. That is the Angel Golden Frieza. We went over his banner, or his potential banner, and also his animations. And overall, I think for, you know, most people, this should be a summon. Obviously, the choice is ultimately still up to you, but I would definitely recommend people to at least do, you know, 3 to 6 multis. Depends on how bad you actually want the Frieza, but you can rest assured that his banner will provide you with good value. Frieza himself is amazing, and that's really all I gotta say. Now, there is an interesting question between whether or not you should be summoning on the Step Up banner or the Angel Golden Frieza banner. And if you haven't already done the three rounds of Step Ups on the New Year's banner, then I think that should still be your priority. Now, of course, there has been a lot of controversy regarding the way they handled LR Ultra Instinct Goku, but even with that, as an issue, I still think the Step Up banner on global provides you with a ton of value, more value than really any other banner can provide. So if you haven't done your step ups, still make that the priority, and then any leftover stones you have, spend those on the Frieza banner if you want him. If not, we still got Tech LR Jiren probably dropping at the end of the month, and then a Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta most likely sometime in February. Okay, so keep those in mind as well as you decide whether or not you want to spend those stones. Okay, so yeah, that's it guys, that's all I gotta say. That is today's video. Let me know in the comments down below whether or not you plan to summon on the Frieza banner, and if so, then how many stones are you gonna be dropping? And that's it. As always, if you guys liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.